Sairam students and welcome back. Today we will be doing a revision of your grammar topic, that is modals. So what are the things involved in this? We'll learn in this particular session. First of all, let's see what are modals. Modals are helping verbs which not only assist in framing questions but also expresses a wide range of meanings. They support the verbs, okay, and making us understand things better. Modals are never used alone but have a principal verb with them. So there's always a main verb and these modals support these principal verbs. These helping verbs are, some of them are can, could, will, would, shall, should, may, might, must, ought to, have to, has to, and had to. So these are the general helping verbs that we often use. These are also known as modal auxiliaries. They are used with the principal verbs. Whatever verbs present, they assist those verbs. Need, dare, and used to are called semi-modals as they can be used either as modal auxiliaries or as a main verb. So these words can be used as a main verb also. So they are named as semi-modals. So I hope you have understood the students. What are the general modals that we use in our day-to-day conversations? Now let's go into the functions. We'll deal with each of them separately. So the first one we take up, the modal verb here is can. What does this can word express? What is the expression? It shows the ability, request, permission, or possibility. So we will just be doing one example of each of these modals. So for the modal verb can, the example given out here is, I can swim across the river. So it is showing the expression of ability, that I can swim. Also, can you grant me leave? This shows permission, kind of a permission to give the person a leave. Then we come to could. Could, again, it's the past tense of can. Here it's again ability, a request, permission, a possibility. So here we see the example given is, could I have a pen? That means you're asking someone, a request is put in to get a pen. Or she could win the game. There is a possibility that she could win the game. Let's move further. Here you can see the modal verb is will. This shows the expression here is willingness, a prediction, determination, and permission. The example here is, we will help you. Okay, it's like willingness to help someone. Or, I will change the system. It's kind of a determination stating that one can change the system. Would again shows the past tense of will. So, here again it's willingness, prediction, determination, and request. So, would you like to spend this evening with me? Or, I wish she would be healthy. So, here again, you are asking someone whether she could spend an evening, also putting forth a wish to do something. Then the expression here is, or the modal verb here is shall, which expresses an advice, a request, warning, or a promise. Like, shall we start the class? So there is a question, there is a suggestion that is put in. We shall get a bicycle if she scores well. So there is a promise made here that if she scores well, a bicycle will be given. Then we have should, It's an obligation, advice and a suggestion. You should not be lazy in advice. We should obey our elders. It's kind of an obligation also that we need to obey our elders. Moving ahead, next modal verb here is may. It expresses a request, possibility, permission, a purpose. So, they may win the match. It expresses possibility. Or, may I come in? Expresses permission. Might is a lesser possibility, a permission, a guess. Okay, she might help us. There's a less possibility that she will help. Or then that might be Rohit. So here you're guessing that somebody is Rohit. So this is the expression of might. Then we have is must. Must expresses an obligation, a prohibition or an assumption. Like you must not bunk school. Or she must be here in the evening. You are assuming this, that she must be here in the evening. Or there is an obligation that you should not bunk school. Ought to expresses a moral obligation or duty or an advice. So here you ought to serve the nation. It's a moral obligation that you serve the nation. You ought to study hard to achieve success. It's an advice given. So, ought to here is used as a moral obligation or a duty also. Okay. Then we have certain modal verbs like have to, has to or had to. So, this again shows obligation or compulsion. Like I have to reach school early. Or she has to work late in the office. So these express some kind of an obligation or compulsion. The next modal verb here is need and need to. So the expression is interrogative or an affirmative sentence. So when it's an interrogative, it is need I speak to him? And if it's an affirmative sentence, I need to go to him. So both these are used as modal verbs. When need to and go. Okay. Then comes used to. Used to is the expression where it shows some kind of a discontinued habit. Something existing in the past. Like for example, he used to drink daily. So the expression here is he used to means it's a habit that was in the past. And drink is the verb out here. Or this used to be a dense jungle before. So something in the past. Used to is used for expressing something in the past. Then we have dare or dare not. This expresses boldness or being courageous. Okay, so dare is a word which as such expresses some kind of a boldness. So the example out here is dare we talk to them. So it is showing a boldness or some kind of a courageous action. I dare not disturb him. So in this regard, we use dare and dare not as a modal verb. Okay, I hope you have understood what the types are, what are the different modals that are used. Go through these. Now, we will just brush up to the type of questions that could be asked in your exams related to this particular topic. One of the questions is, fill in the blanks with appropriate modals. For example, you will be given the options. So you have to pick out which is the most suitable modal for that particular sentence. So here you have dash you like to have a sandwich. So it could be Would you like to have a sandwich or could you like to have a sandwich? So the answer would be, would you like to have a sandwich? The second one is I-B-25 next birthday. The options given are shall or must. So here the answer would be shall. I shall be 25 next birthday. So this is one kind of a question that can be asked in your exams. Another kind of a question would be, complete the passage by filling in the blanks with appropriate modals. For example, you have God is great and we dash be grateful to him. We dash do our duty and leave the reward in the hands of God. Ultimately, God dash help us. So you can see the options given here, must or need. So the first blank would be, we must. Must is the answer. The second one is, should, we should do our duty, and God will help us. So these kind of questions will be asked where individual blanks you will get options. You have to select the correct one and put in that particular answer in that particular blank, or probably click on that particular answer. So I hope you have understood what modals is. Go through the section very well. Now we will move ahead to the next topic, that is determiners. So what are determiners? We'll just go through. Determiners are words that modify nouns. They are words that can be used before nouns to determine or modify their meaning. Determiners function like adjectives. They are also called fixing words. So there are different types of determiners that we use. So they are used to modify or understand the nouns in a better way. They function like an adjective also. Certain characteristics of determiners are, it may determine or fix a place, person, or thing. It may identify two or more persons or things. So this is the main characteristics. You are able to understand what exactly the noun is functioning as. It may precede numerals or objects. It may indicate a quantity or amount. So these are the different characteristics that a determiner functions as in a particular sentence. So now let's see what are the different classifications of determiners. You can see this table out here. There are the different types of determiners mentioned here. You have articles, you have quantifiers, demonstratives, numbers, distributives, you have possessives, difference verbs, defining verbs. So these are all the different types of determiners. They are a kind of noun modifier. They precede and are necessarily followed by nouns. They always, you will find them before a particular noun. So you can just go through this table wherein you will find different kinds. What are the actual characteristics of each? We'll deal with them individually in the next slides. So just go through this particular table very carefully so you get a quick understanding of what determiners are. You must have done this also in the previous lesson videos. So this is a recap so that at a glance you're able to understand what determiners are. So moving further, now we will see examples related to each of these determiners. So first we have here is articles. We have learnt of articles a, an, and the. So we will learn the determiner and one or two examples of each kind. So under articles we have she had an orange. So an orange, an becomes the determiner out here. The book you want is available. The is the determiner. The next type is quantifiers, which includes much, more, little. There is quantity involved in this, which explains the noun better. For example, I haven't got much change. So much is the quantifier in this particular sentence. There is little water left in the tank. So little becomes the determiner. It's a quantifier out here. Moving ahead, the next type is demonstratives, which includes this, that, these, those, which are demonstrating something about the noun. So you have examples here is this book is very interesting. So this indicates the demonstrative used here. Those houses are for sale. So those becomes the determiner, demonstrative. Next we have numerals or numbers. That is, you have cardinal and ordinal numbers. So she was the first to reach the party. So you have first. First becomes a numeral. They had three books left in the stock. So three. Three is again a number that is used as a determiner in this particular sentence, which explains the noun. The next kind is distributives, where you have distribution quality, like all, everyone, each. Okay, so the example out here is he ate all the apples. So all becomes the distributor, that he ate everything. And each person is important. So again, a distributor, each and every person is important. So each is a determiner, as person becomes the noun out here. The next kind of determiner here is possessive. That is generally the possessive pronouns that you know about. Mine, yours, theirs, hers, his. All these come under these possessives, which again we use them as determiners in the sentences. So this book is mine. So mine here is the possessive used. Her hair looks pretty. So her becomes the possessive pronoun or the determiner here, which is explaining the noun, giving some kind of a weightage or explanation to the noun. The next kind is a difference words. Like you have other, another used in your sentences. So please bring me another pen. So another is a difference verb, where this is also a determiner. I met him the other day. Other is the determiner used in this sentence. Certain defining words also are part of the determiners, like which and whose. Generally, these come under the where you have interrogative sentences. Which book were you talking about? So here, which becomes a defining word. Whose helmet is that? So whose again is the determiner here, which is supporting the noun. Okay. So these were the different types of determiners which you have learnt in earlier also. It's a revision. Go through these slides really well. Now we will just go through the types of questions that can be asked for your exams. So the first kind is just fill in the blanks with appropriate determiners. Okay. For example, the first sentence here is copper is dash useful metal. Options given is A and an. So you have to choose the correct one. What could be the correct answer here? Copper is a useful metal. The second sentence here is, I met dash people in my life. Options here are many or much. So the answer would be, I met many people in my life. Okay, I hope students you are understanding. Another question that can be asked is, complete the passage choosing the most appropriate option. Like you can see here, you can see the passage here. Mark Twain was the pen name of Samuel Clemens dash was one of dash greatest fiction writers of America. He grew up in small town dash the banks of Mississippi River. So you can see, you can see here, you have options given for each blank. Okay, so you have to select the appropriate option from them. So here it would be, Mark Twain was the pen name of Samuel Clemens, who was one of the greatest fiction writers of America. He grew up in a small town on the banks of the Mississippi River. So this kind of questions can also be asked, wherein you have to fill in choosing the correct option. Students, I hope you have understood what determiners are. Go through the previous videos also. Go through your notes that are provided to you so that you can understand both topics, modals and determiners, really well. Now, I will just brush up with this two topics, that is tenses and reported speech. We have already completed with the lesson videos, and also the revision videos have been sent. These two topics, the revision videos, have been shared with you even earlier. So go through the rules pertaining to these topics very thoroughly. Everything is explained with examples even in the lesson videos and also the revision videos that have been sent to you earlier. So do go through these videos. Notes also have been provided to you, with exercises are given to you. So go through these. I'll just give you some kind of understanding about what kind of questions can be asked in your exams pertaining to these topics. So here in tenses, one kind could be, fill in the blanks using the correct form of the verb. You have options given, you have to choose the correct form of that particular and answer them. Okay. She dash the food tomorrow. So the options here are, will be cooking, cooks, is cooking, had cooked. So understanding what the sentence is, what kind of tense it is, the appropriate form would be, she will be cooking the food tomorrow. So you need to understand what form it is and what tense it is and give the answer. Another kind of a sentence is, complete the passage choosing the correct option. So here you have a passage, I dash German for 5 years now, but last year I dash hard. I dash harder this time. So again, you have options given for every blank. So the correct ones would be, I have been learning German for 5 years now, but last year I did not work hard. I shall study harder this time. So in this way, you have to complete the passage. Okay. Now, with the reported speech, the kind of questions would be, change the following to reported speech. For example, he said, I will study the book. So you see the options here is, he said that I will study the book, or he said that he would study the book. So understanding the rules related to changing to reported speech, the correct one would be, he said that he would study the book. So you have to go through your videos really well. another form would be you will be given a dialogue and sentences where you have to complete that reported speech. So dialogue given here is between the doctor and the patient. How do you feel now? Patient says slightly better. The doctor says, did you take the medicines? Patient says, yes. This is totally in direct speech. Now, when it is in a reported speech form, you have to fill in with the correct options. There are options given. So, what would be the correct options out here? Doctor asks the patient how he felt. The patient replied that he felt slightly better. When the doctor asked him if he had taken the medicines, he replied in affirmation. So these are the type of questions you will get even in these two topics. So understand them, go through your videos, go through your lessons, your notes. Learn the rules applicable to these topics so that you will be able to do the paper in a really good way. All the best. Thank you.